Buffalo Bills, they have a couple things to decide, whether or not in free agencies, Shaq Lawson, you got Jordan Phillips. They're one of the top 100 free agencies, according to CBS. Are they going to get them? Are they going to lose one, keep both, whatever?
I don't think they're able to keep either of them. I think they're both in line for a big payday. Listen, the Bills did this to themselves with Shaq Lawson. Granted, I would not have signed on for the fifth-year option either the way that he was going. And you can make the argument, again, I've said it before, my fear is that both Shaq Lawson and Jordan Phillips perform well because they were in contract years. But you look at the franchise tag. The Bills announced on Tuesday they would not be franchise tagging anybody on the roster, which means Spain, Phillips, and Shaq Lawson can walk. You're looking at between $11 and $15 million a year, potentially, to keep Shaq Lawson and Jordan Phillips. With what you have on the roster, what you can find economically in the draft, I don't think they're worth either of them worth that money. Harrison Phillips is not as explosive as Jordan Phillips is, but he was making strides last year before he blew his knee out. You burned a third-round pick on him 2 years ago. I would rather give him the opportunity to grow than pay a guy that's had issues in the NFL in Jordan Phillips. And Shaq Lawson, same situation.
Very good defense for the Buffalo Bills. It seems like the Bills, though, are talking a lot of offense, Matt, when it comes to the combine, which I'm not quite sure if the combine is a true test of whether a player can play.
A lot of people say that. A lot of people say these are not game situations per se, even though they have the individual drills. I look at it like you guys have to look at Chris Johnson, Vernon Davis. Yes, you have the bust like Matt Jones, the quarterback out of Arkansas, who's trying to be a wide receiver, DeMarcus Van Dyke. A lot of people don't know in terms of if they turn into bust or not. Mm-hmm. But I think instead of overrating bust, you're not going to have a lot of that in comparison to just having guys get more exposure that deserve it, that are worthy of it. CJ2K, he becomes that because he has the combine. He runs such a good 40. And coming out of East Carolina, he needed that added exposure. I mean, Vernon Davis becomes one of the highest drafted ever tight ends because he's such a physical specimen. I think more so than not, it pans out, even though there's plenty of guys that are bust because of what they do in the combine.
I'm worried about the combine because we tend to focus a lot on this 40-yard dash. We tend to worry about whether or not Burroughs has the right hand size for the football.
Well, I mean, he is only 9 inches. It's not.
I didn't even measure, nor do I even care. But will it actually result in success on the field? I mean, we all saw Tom Brady's combine. He didn't look too great.
Some of his shirt off, not fantastic at all.
But then how many Super Bowls are we counting?
True, but I mean, again, you can go down a hole. Listen, I'm with you on the fact that the measurables don't really matter. You look at a guy like Devin Singletary last season, right? The reason that he ends up where he does coming out of a small school was because of a poor 40-yard dash time. He was arguably the best rookie running back in the league last year based on the time that he played. No, I mean, this whole thing's a joke. They're all lottery tickets anyway. You have all of this film from every single one of these players. Then they go to these all-star college football games, the smaller school guys. You get to see them play against that. I don't know how much an intelligent general manager should allow his opinion to be swayed based on what he's seeing in Indianapolis. And it's like throwing a bunch of lottery tickets in the air, and the one that comes down the fastest is the one you want to take, right?
Matt, is a pro day a little bit better? It's just an organized workout with receivers that this quarterback or player has been around for the last couple of weeks.
I think the pro day is better, and you're seeing it with a couple guys. KJ Hamler's not running till the pro day. Chase Young, who could be like a top five pick, he says he's not doing it until the Buckeyes pro day. What you're seeing is obviously lesser talent because it's only one school involved, and because they're going up against or having drills with guys, like you said a second ago, their own receivers, they're going to be more helpful. It's just going to be guys looking out for each other. So I think the pro day, to a certain degree, is better.